Kajabi recently released a feature that I'm super pumped to share with you about in this video, and that is Kajabi Payments. Kajabi Payments allows you to accept like Apple Pay, Google Pay, or credit cards without having to have a swipe or a PayPal account. Kajabi will handle the transactions for you in the software. Now, if you don't know much about Kajabi, Kajabi is an all-in-one online business management tool that allows you to manage your entire online business all in one place. And it allows you to take what you love doing and turn it into a full-time career. Now, if you haven't experienced the awesomeness and simplicity of Kajabi yet, it may be your lucky day because I'm extending an exclusive limited time Kajabi offer for 20% off all monthly packages for a year with no strings attached. That's on any monthly plan. You'll receive 20% off every monthly plan. All you got to do is follow my special link at michaelgoms.com/Kajabi. Now, there's one single caveat, and that is that this promotion only lasts for 1 week. So from October 4th to October 11th, 2023, you'll be able to get this 20% off all monthly packages through my link at michaelgoms.com/Kajabi. If you're watching this video after October 11th, 2023, I apologize. You will not be able to get that discount, but I still will be offering at the same link a 30-day free trial of Kajabi, which is double their standard 14-day free trial. And I want to give this to you so that you have time, especially if you're kicking the tires, you want to check out Kajabi, you want to see if it's a good fit for your business. This gives you plenty of time. Plus, I'm going to give you bonuses. I'm going to give you my Kajabi Kickstart free course, which will help you not only get up and running on the technical side of Kajabi, but it'll also teach you a lot of the strategies and things you can use to get started today. Now, I'm super excited to show you this new feature of the Kajabi payments in Kajabi. So let's jump over to my computer and I'll walk you through it. So here we are in my Kajabi dashboard, and I'm down here on the left-hand side under the settings section because this is where we're going to start. I want you to go to this place called Payment Integrations. And if we go in here, this is where you're going to actually set up your payment providers. As you can see here right now, I only have the option for Kajabi Payments because that's all I've decided to use. But if you click on Use Other Providers here, up until now, this is all they offered, Stripe and PayPal. So I've disconnected my PayPal and Stripe accounts because I choose to use Kajabi Payments. It just makes it simpler. It's more integrated. Kajabi handles all the payments. And as you can see over here on the right-hand side, I'm connected, so I can't really show you how to set it up, but it's really simple. They just ask you for some banking information and ask you to connect, very similar to how they ask you to connect to Stripe. So if we want to click on these three dots by the Stripe where it says Connect Stripe, if I click on this, then you just follow the instructions for creating your Stripe account and logging into Stripe. I've actually deleted my Stripe account, so I don't have one. But again, Kajabi makes it so simple to walk through and set it up for you. So that's where you go to initially set up your payment integrations. Now what I want to show you is how to create a new offer and integrate it into that offer and that checkout page. So let's go into the sales tab. That's going to take us to our offers. I want to start from scratch. I want to show you guys. We're just going to call this temp coaching offer. Okay, because we're right here under products, I'm going to attach my Mike's business coaching product. This is my monthly coaching package, and I'm going to attach it to this offer. Okay, now we want this offer. Let's say we wanted to obviously collect money for this, so we are going to set up a payment, so it's going to be paid, not free, and we want this just to be a one-time payment. As you can see here, it gives you options for like multi-pay. You can take several payments. You can have a subscription, like a monthly subscription. We're just going to do a single one-time payment. We're going to make the price, let's make it $250. We'll just make it, keep it simple. And then what we want to do is select a payment type. So right here, when I click on this dropdown, this is normally where it would give you like Stripe or PayPal. I want to go ahead and click on Kajabi payment because I want to give my customers as many options to pay as possible. And Kajabi makes it super simple, so I really don't have to deal with any of that. So right here, the only option I really have to click on is Apple Pay. And my guess is because I'm on a Mac and I don't have my Google Pay set up, so it's not going to show me the Google Pay option. But that's okay, because I actually love Apple Pay and I use Apple Pay for everything else as well. So I'm going to click Save and Finish. Okay, so here's our temp coaching offer page with all the information. You can see over here on the right-hand side, we have our offer pricing, $250. We have our title. You can also do an internal title if that's optional. If you want a different title for, you know, for internal purposes, you can write a description here. Let's just write a quick, simple description. This is a temporary coaching offer, dummy offer, just so I remember to delete it later. And as you can see, as you scroll down here, this is where normally when you create an offer, you can add as many products here as you want. So if you've created, you know, however many products you've created, but let's say you're creating an offer and this is a bundle. So you're bundling, maybe you're coaching, maybe you're offering with this $250, maybe you're offering a free course, a free ebook, maybe access to a community or a membership. You could add that here just by clicking add product. And then it gives you the drop-down option that we saw before to add a product. As you can see here, I just have the Kajabi Kickstart course right now. That's showing that I could add here. This is the one that if you sign up through my link at michaelgoms.com/Kajabi, you get access to my Kajabi free Kickstart course. And there's a whole bunch of other settings here and things, but what I really want to do is get this launched so I can show you what the checkout's going to look like. So let's click save. Now, another great place, like if you want to add Google Pay or something after the fact, if you want to change your settings, you're going to go up here under the title Temp Coaching Offer and choose pricing. Okay, and this basically gives you the settings that we already used to set up our coaching program. And as you can see here, they actually went ahead and gave me the option now to click Google Pay. I'm not sure why they did it after the fact instead of letting me do it on sign up, but there we go. So now I can turn on Google Pay and now I can offer those options as well. And then see this button right next to save where it says edit checkout. That's what we want to do because we want to edit our checkout page so that when our customers go there to purchase this offer, they'll see the different options they have for checking out. As you can see here, this is a very basic offer page. This is pretty much Kajabi's offer page. I love it because it's clean, simple. There's not a lot of customization that can be done. I mean, you can change out the banner image or remove the banner altogether, and you can change a few colors. But other than that, it's pretty simple. And I love that about Kajabi because then I don't have to think too much. I can just get my products out and sell them. So as you can see here, right now, it's only asking for the email address, and it is giving us the option right here for a credit card. So we kind of see the option for a credit card right here. What I want to do is I'm going to add a couple more form fields. So if I come over here on the left-hand side, let's say we want to collect their name, and we also maybe want to collect their phone number. As you see, at least this is on Safari, I'm not sure about on Chrome, but if I click these, it doesn't auto update over here on the right hand side. So you have to click save up here in the upper left hand corner, and then it'll update on the right hand side. Okay, so this gives us a very basic overview. Okay, we haven't really added any information about our product or any bullet points or anything like that. Let's go up here to the upper right hand side where it says preview and click preview and see what this page looks like. As you can see here, here's our form, and it shows credit card or Apple Pay. Now, for some reason, I'm assuming, again, it's because I'm on Safari and I don't have Google Pay set up. It's not going to show me that Google Pay right now. So that's basically it for setting up your offer and your checkout page. Now, what I want to do is I want to jump over to my website and show you how they have this new feature. I believe it's currently in beta and only certain people have access to it right now, but you may have access to it if you sign up today. I'm not sure, but there's an option for a pop-up where people can pay for your products right there on your website page by just using a call to action button, which you can actually place anywhere. So let's jump over to my website real quick. So here we are on a website page that I'm currently working on. And what I'm going to show you how to do is just simply add a call to action button on the screen, because once you get the idea or the premise behind it, you'll be able to do this anywhere on your website or on any of your sales landing pages, anything like that. So on the left-hand side, as you can see here on the canvas, we're at the bottom of the canvas because you can see my footer. I'm going to scroll down the left-hand side to where it says add section. Now I'm going to just choose right here this call to action option, okay, which is now going to place, and then I'm going to click add, and that's going to place this call, this gray call to action button here at the bottom of my site. If I click on this call to action button over here on the left-hand side, it's going to pull up the settings for that call to action button, and right here it says button action. So I'm going to click on this drop-down. And you see how it gives you the option to open the pop-up checkout beta? So that's the beta that I was talking about. I'm gonna choose that. And then in the next drop-down, I'm gonna choose the offer. Let's choose the temp coaching offer that we just created. And then I'm gonna come up to the right-hand corner and click save. Now I wanna click preview on this page and I wanna show you what this button does. So if we scroll all the way to the bottom, here's our gray call to action button. Now, if I click on this, let's say I'm promoting that coaching product in this text right here, right? And I want to click on this button. Watch what's going to happen. See, the checkout pop-up actually pops up. Now, this is a new feature. I love this feature. And I'm going to show you even more in a second why I love this feature, because you can literally put this anywhere without having to send them to the checkout page. So it just gives them a better customer experience. And it makes it so that you're more likely to get payments instead of, because every step that you put your customer or your client through is one step that may take away from a sale. So the simpler you can make the process for them, the easier it is for you to make money. So as you can see here in the checkout pop-up, we have our payment methods right here. We have credit card and we have Apple Pay. They can store their card for future purchases and fill out their information just like they would on the checkout page. So this is an amazing feature. Now I want to show you how to do the same thing in a blog post. And what's cool about this is the exact same process. Let's jump over to my blog. Okay, so this is a blog post that I recently posted. It's going to look a little funny on this page because on my desktop, I have it a little stretched out for video purposes. So it's going to look a little funny, but we're going to scroll down here to the bottom. And over here on the left-hand side, you can see blog post body. So if you're editing your blog post body, right, which is this body, we're going to click on that. And I'm going to scroll all the way to the bottom because we've got two options here. So on the bottom of my blog post, you can see that I have a blog post opt-in. That's this option right here where my cursor is, okay? And I have the opt-in turned on for people to sign up for my newsletter. But right up above that, there's a blog post call to action, okay? Now, two cool ways that you can use the pop-up checkout beta and the Kajabi payments in here. One is the current blog post opt-in that I have has a form in it, right? I'm collecting their first name and email for my newsletter. So if I want to edit this form so that when they submit their info, the pop-up will pop up for them to purchase whatever product I'm marketing here, go over here to the left-hand side to blog post opt-in, click on that, come down here to thank you page, okay? And then do the drop-down and select open pop-up checkout beta. And then the same thing, select your coaching offer. And then what that's going to do is as soon as they submit their info for this form, let's say I wasn't using it for a newsletter, let's say I was using it for something else, or for maybe it was an advertisement for the coaching that's basically embedded in my blog post, they just put their first name and email in here, then the pop-up comes up and they can purchase it right there. Okay, that is really cool. Now, the other way that we can use this, if we go back, as you notice, it was also a call to action button that can be added at the bottom. So on the left-hand side, it says blog post call to action. If I go in here and I check this box that says show call to action, you'll see on the right-hand side that this black call to action button appears above the other form, okay? That's because if you don't want to have this form on here, you just want to have the exact same information if you're trying to sell that, maybe that coaching package, but you don't want to have a form, you just want to have a button for the pop-up. So the same thing on the homepage, except for you can't just click on this button to edit it. Go to the left-hand side where it says blog post call to action, where we just turned it on, scroll down to where it says button action, and then choose that open pop-up checkout beta, and it's the same exact process. So I hope this video has been helpful for you to kind of demonstrate and show to you how much I love Kajabi. And they're constantly adding features. As if they're already not amazing enough, they're constantly adding features almost on a weekly basis. I get emails with new features that they've added either to the community or for membership sites or cool stuff like this, like Kajabi Payments. They really are the ultimate all-in-one online business tool platform. And I absolutely love them. They have simplified my life so much. So don't forget, if you want to test drive Kajabi today, you can get a 14-day free trial along with 20% off of all their monthly packages for a year simply by going to michaelgoms.com/Kajabi and using my link to sign up. Plus you'll get that free course, that free 45-minute coaching call, and that free ebook to show you the strategies and systems to start making money online in your first 30 days. Keep in mind that if you're watching this after October 11th, 2023, that you can still go to my link and get all the bonuses that I've mentioned, plus a 30-day free trial. That's double the free trial that they offer in order to test drive Kajabi. So either way, we've got deals going on. Go over to michaelgoms.com/Kajabi. And if you're new here and you haven't subscribed yet, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you guys in the next video.